others who we think are more important than us. But Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam listened to everybody. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يكره أن يقوم له أحد. He didn't want anybody to stand up for him, so he sits down, subhanAllah. Very humble. And that's what we all have to realize. We all have to be humble. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كره شيئاً عرف ذلك في وجهه. If he dislikes something, you will know. He doesn't hide. There is no cunning. It's right there on his face. And they tell us that when they went into Mecca, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم has given 10 names of people that should be killed regardless because of all the harm they did for Islam. One of them said that الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم would dictate the Quran to me and I write different things, the wrong things. So الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم chose a list and wrote. So one of these men, after the Fath Mecca, the Muslims, he came to الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم and asked for forgiveness. And الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم looked the other side. And the man kept asked for forgiveness. So الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, okay, go. And then after he left, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, you had my orders. Anybody who sees him, regardless where, he should be killed for all the bad things he did. They said, Ya Rasulullah, only if you winked at us to tell us, just give us a sign. He said, I am a prophet. I don't wink at anybody. I don't do these bad things. You had my orders and you didn't fulfill. And now I set him free. Subhanallah. So his face shows how he feels. Don't hide things. And that's what we have to. If we're angry, we have to show we're angry. Don't hide it. But the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only got angry for the hudud Allah, but not for himself. He never got angry for himself. But if somebody did something against Islam, he was angry. And that reminds us of a hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, if people are on a ship and they divided the ship, people who live upstairs and those who live downstairs, and the ship is going through a river of clear water and the people downstairs got thirsty. So some of them said, rather than wake the people upstairs at night, why don't we drill a hole and we get clear water from the bottom? So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if the people upstairs, living upstairs in the ship, let this go, everybody will drown. And then he said, كَذَلِكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ. If you see somebody doing something wrong against hududullah and you stay quiet, everybody will drown. So when you see something wrong that Allah said it's haram, you have to speak out, subhanallah. And that's why maybe the hadith where when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Ibrahim to destroy a town and he said it has one good man who worship you, ya Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said start with him. Why? Because he seen al-haram and he didn't speak out. He just stayed by himself for himself. We have to speak out. And when we see something wrong, we have to speak out. Just like the people in the ship, if they stayed quiet about those because they don't touch us, those who's digging in the bottom, everybody will drown. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يبغض الكذب. He hated lying, subhanAllah, يبغض الكذب. And as I mentioned before, it always comes in my mind. If I'm in a restaurant and I'm seeing a Muslim drinking, I despise this and I feel bad. But the same thing, if we are around the same table and you see a Muslim lying, it doesn't have that same despise in our heart. Why is it? Even though maybe the guy who's drinking is only doing harm for himself, the guy is lying is hurting all Muslims because a Muslim does not lie. And yet our feeling, what goes inside us when we see somebody drinking is much worse. We don't care if somebody's lying. And yet we care if he's drinking, subhanAllah. But Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yabghad al-kadib. He despises lying and he doesn't like the people to lie. And we as Muslims have to realize we should not lie because if we lie, we can do everything. If we promise ourselves not to lie, we will find that we will not do anything else wrong. Because if somebody asks us and we know we don't lie, so we know we should not do anything wrong, subhanAllah. So the basis of anything wrong is we know that we can lie and hide it. If we know we cannot lie and we cannot hide it, a Muslim will not do anything wrong. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَخَفُّ النَّاسِ صَلَاةً عَنْ النَّاسِ. When he led the prayers, he led a light prayers. And then when he prayed for himself, he prayed a long time. And we see this is the opposite. If we have an imam, he wants to show off that he knows so much Quran, and sometimes you wonder if he's ever going to go down for ruku'ah. And yet if you watch him by himself, he does two quick rak'ahs, subhanallah. Opposite to a sunnat Rasulullah. Sunnat Rasulullah, where Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the imams, make it short, because there is a mother who's worried about her child, a sick older person beyond you, you don't know who's beyond you, so make it short. And then when you want to pray by yourself, take as much time as you like, read as much as you like. And yet we always do the opposite of sunnat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And finally, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَلَّا لَا يَنَامْ إِلَّا وَالسَّوَاكَ عَنْدَ رَأْسِهِ. He slept with the swag, that piece of wood, to brush his teeth at his head. The first thing he does when he wakes up is use the swag, subhanallah. And for those of you who use the swag, you feel it has a medicine in it. It tastes like medicine, it has a medicine, and it's good for the teeth, subhanallah. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used it all the time. However, I remember reading for a Sheikh al-Ghazali. He said he was giving a lecture at the university and one of his students was doing swag. So Sheikh al-Ghazali told him, it's not appropriate in my class to do swag. So the young man said, this is sunnat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's why I'm doing it. He said, and we know the sunnah is to wash yourself after you go to the washroom. Does that mean you do it anytime in front of people? Subhanallah. So yes, there is time and place to do everything, and time and place to follow a sunnah. But one of the sunnah is a swag, and to keep the swag on us. And yes, it has medicine, and yes, it is good for us. And may we follow sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are some of the things we learn from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we said, our challenge is to break that barrier between non-Muslims and Islam. And we have built that barrier and we have to break it. Just as we said in the beginning of the speech, the man who stopped the thief and by giving him money and bread and telling him I'm a Muslim, the thief had become a Muslim and wanted to be like him, a Muslim. This is this is what all of us have to do. This is our mission for each one of us. Not to tell people go and be Muslims, to show people how wonderful Islam is. And everybody is smart, everybody who sees something nice wants to follow. So the idea is not to go and tell people Islam is great, the idea is to show that it's great on you, how much you enjoy it, how it changed your life, and people will watch and say, Subhanallah, I want to be like this. Reminding me that at a place of work, when we were praying Jama'ah, Al-Maghrib Jama'ah one day, and most of the Muslims went to pray, and the non-Muslim sat, and he said, I watch you Muslim praying, and I hear this recitation. I don't understand what it means, but it gave me peace of mind. Subhanallah. مَنْ قَالَ عَلَى اللَّهُ وَعَمَلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. If we keep doing these good deeds, rather than trying to force the message on anybody, people will follow if they see the impact on us, see that we have a peaceful, wonderful life. People, that's what people want. So inshallah, we break this barrier by acting Islam and living Islam, rather than we want to live the Western way and tell people that Islam is wonderful and they can't see it. Islam is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah tells us, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورديت لكم إسلام دينا. Subhanallah, it's a great blessing. And it's a great religion and it's complete. Doesn't need any of us to tell us to complete it. It's complete and it is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we enjoy this blessing and accept it, others will too, inshallah. Allahumma inna maulana fi man hadayt. وعافنا في من عافيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم بارك لنا فيما أعطيت اللهم لا تجعل لنا في جمعنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا مريدا إلا شفيته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا ذيلا إلا قضيته ولا حاجة لنا في هذه الدنيا لكن لك فيها الرضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.